aligns better, I think. Alright? So yeah, alignment. So it's lift from the belly button. Your shoulders just go. Align to the wall behind you. Imaginary wall. Bring your whole body back through space. Hands are by your side. Breathe. Now lengthen. Just even lengthen. See your whole vertebrae just lift and it's up. Beautiful. There you go. Breathe in and reach overhead. And breathe out. Come back down. So now come up. Breathe in. You're in perfect alignment. Your hands are in perfect alignment. I want you to move your head back behind like you're doing a back bend, but I want you to keep your arms up. And there's that lift, lengthen, align, and then do that back bend. Breathe out. And then breathe in and come up. Bring your hands back. Go back at neutral. Put your flat back forward. Breathe out. Bring your hands around behind. Bring your nose to your knees. Straighten your legs. Drop your head to the ground. Breathe. And come back, flat back, airplane arms up. Breathe. So now just go one, two, pick up the speed, back up. Two, and breathe, up. Breathe, lift. Nice. Now come back, and when you come here, go down. Grab behind, pull your nose to your knee, breathe out. Sit back in a chair. Bring your arms out behind you, palm down, and come back up. Breathe. So that's the airplane arm. Up, look. Perfect. So this will start in front of it, open. As we did front and back, let's just do side to side, right? So it's torso rotation, the whole hip, and shoulders, breathe. Yep. And then come up, now reach. Now in that same thing, come rotate. Reach, now lift, right here. You just activated your psoas with that same lift. Feel it?
Yeah.
Well, what's the psoas do, you know?
Does it connect the quad through the hips?
Upper body to the lower body. And if that's a lot of people who have tight backs, right? And back pain, hip issues, it's psoas. Breathe, it's lift. Align. Now lengthen. Look up and it's this. Good. Switch. Breathe. The feet don't lift. Okay, one more. Breathe. And then come back up. Breathe. Here. And then it's side. Okay, so your hip goes one way. Now, notice what you're doing. Because you're tight. You don't like it. We automatically go to what we don't like. When we're uncomfortable or stressed humans, do things for whatever reason. And 90% of the humans go with this. We bring it up into this area for whatever reason, probably because that's our stress emotion area and that's what we're trying to protect. But what we need to do is do it in our ab. Squeeze your ab if you have to squeeze anything. Think how ripped we'd all be.
Yeah, right.
Right? So you don't like that side motion. It's tight for you, so you want to lean a little, and so you're not letting yourself lean. So bring your hands down here. Keep your head, shoulder, hip back against the wall. And breathe. Head back. Now let your hip release. The groin, opposite groin. Head is back. And breathe in. Go the other way. Breathe out. So it's just hip. Right? It's just hip. I'm showing it sideways. Here, hip. Now look up if you would like. Rotate literally your whole head sideways and look up. Good. I try to really work on that rotation even a little more. Yeah, see the difference?
Yeah.
That even isolates that oblique more. Now come on, open this upper arm. Breathe. Now, just let's add a little bit of dynamic to this. So it's reach as far away as you can, and then bring your arm down and around. Reach. And then up, breathe out, down, around. Good. And then squat. Step in. Other way. Up. Yeah. I think we're going to take all of these little extra things we just did and we're going to make them into strength. Okay. So from here, stay here. Right, you're going to hold it and then you're going to bring your hand here. Now look ahead, get a good little hip stretch, breathe out, and look ahead as much as you can. Actually, that feels good. back squat and straighten and squat and try to keep a flat back, and if you can get your head down, squat and then up, breathe in and breathe out and go that other way, step the other way, squat, straighten, squat, stand up. Squat to the ground, go the other way, so we just switch. Squat, stand, drop your head, come back, squat, and explode up. Breathe, one more, down, two, straighten, two, squat, two, and back. Feels kind of good, doesn't it?
Yeah, it feels really good. It's helping me get straight on my
head. Breathe, right? So here, we're tricking it. That's that stretch reflex, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And come back. That's that stretch reflex I always talk about and how we trick it with active isolated stretching. Alright?
Sorry.
Your muscles send a signal to your brain.
You deserve to see your people.
And it's
you also deserve the lowest after price
1.5 seconds.
So
all right,
that is
figured
out.
Your muscles start going a little bit big off.
Oh
no, this is more than what we're used to. We're going to get hurt. We better stop. So it sends pain to your brain. And your brain goes, oh, okay, and it backs off. So we try to trick that. We go just right before it sends the signal, and you get a little stretch. So then the next time, instead of going to here, you can go to here. So then from there, we go to there. So by the time we're done, just after 10 of them, your brain thinks that this used to be the motion, but now it can do this. It works.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool.
I know, that's what I just got to train my body to use all the positions.
You will.
It's like, I feel like I can get my hand down in certain places, but I just can't. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I physically should be able to, but mentally I'm not.
You're holding it back.
Yeah,
isn't that interesting? Because you're holding on somewhere, wherever you hold. So what is it? Not fear. But whenever you get
uncomfortable, yeah.
Your body is something. So we need to figure out what you're holding on with.
Yeah.
You have to.
It's my low back.
All right, so then we'll work on releasing it.
It's so tight. Like, I can do a back bend into it, but then like I can't do like the...
Come on.
Yeah.
All right, so let's do a little bit of a chair just for a minute. So come to chair. So your shoulders are back. Now, when you're in a yoga pose, you always kind of try to want to bring your hands to letter W. Right, and when you do, you squeeze in. Right, you're not hucking, it's just squeeze those elbows. And now come here. Now bring your hands prayer. It's heart center. That's what that's about. It's all about, it's coming from here. I hope to talk about that someday. And it's here. No, that should all be in your butt, not your neck at all. I see it's in your neck. You're going like this. It has nothing to do with your neck. Release all your upper body, but still maintain in space. It's in and back. Breathe, it's down. Two, come up and reach overhead and do a back bend. And back, chair. And this should be pretty loose for you. One, two, up, back. Only now this time I want you to rotate your right elbow to your left knee. But you literally have to come from your lower back in your hip. So make it smooth. Bring the elbow to the knee. Come up, switch, down. Bring your left elbow to your knee. And it comes from a rotation. Right? We rotate much better. See that already? So now bring your hands. Push up on with that top hand and down. Now try to look up. Feel that. If your lower back is tight, you're going to feel that in your lower back. So now that's your QL, that's your quadratus lumborum. That's the opposite muscle from the psoas that we just talked about. Chair and breathe. Rotate. Look up. Back middle. Up and back. We're doing a lot of squats. So on top of getting mobile, we're getting flexible. Breathe, rotate, lift, and look up. Breathe out. One more each way, you think?
Sure.
So this time we go squat, rotate. Now, if you want, arm that you're rotating to the knee. For me, it's my left. Drop that arm down along the shin. Open your top arm. And that's going to even out a little more. And breathe. Come back to the middle of the chair. Breathe, reach back. And then one more. Other way. Rotate. Settle it in. Drop. Reach. Breathe. Open. Come back. My one yoga pose skiers should do. Chair and all the modifications. So let's just offset that a little bit with a crescent lunge pose. Mavis, she wants to be. She doesn't like the noise. She's afraid of the noise.
It's okay.
Dogs can be strange. Dogs can be strange. Yeah, she'll be fine. She'll move once you stop moving. I'll keep them up if you want.
Come on.
Actually, there you go. All right. So it's going to be crescent lunge. What we just did. It's going to be step back, right? Well, that's the strength is in the control of the stepping back. A lot of people, they go like this, right? You didn't do that. It's high knee, and it's very controlled. You step back, and you're ready. If I want you to come very quickly forward, you can. Right? So that's crescent lunge. And relax and breathe. And then bring your hands in front of you. And then come up to a standing split. As much as you can straighten the front bottom leg, don't even worry about your top leg. And relax your upper body. Relax it. Let it drop. With a straight leg. Now try to lift your leg to the sky. Breathe out. Look up. The hips want to be pointing down. Now come to crescent lunge from this in one motion. Very controlled. It's your front glute you squeeze, not your front toes. This is a little more advanced pose. Now if you want to make it even more, you're going to come here, right? And you're going to add that revolve when you're just doing it. So then you come up, and back, and down. Like back, straighten fully when you come back, straighten that front leg fully, yeah, you switch to the other side, remember, step up, high knee, very much in control, back, we're strengthening our glutes, stop, we work so much in anterior mode. Forward. We need to be breathing. Right? Good. Now you can go forward. But again, you're still pushing up from the back part of your body. The whole front is relaxed. And drop back. Swung. Control. Back. Crescent lunge. Breathe. Crescent lunge. Tip your toes forward. Back leg is straight. Breathe out. Drop your head. Just out, you'll feel it. And then back. And then straight. Now we're going to add that chair pose. Twisting chair. We're going to twist crescent lunge. Toes. Notice how your whole hip, your hip and your shoulder and your heel all stay in line. And then up and back, straighten your front leg, reach back, drop that back foot. Nice. Breathe out, get it out of your neck. Relax your neck. There's nothing to do with it.
Tie you back up, crazy doggy.
Sorry.
Hey. It's so funny, whenever she does something bad, like she ate my shoe yesterday, she goes right to this, and I yell at her, she goes right to this, so then I get, and then I feel bad, she looks so cute.
No, she's not cute, she's rotten as the day is long, and she ate your shoes.
I know, I don't even care, I was like, well, I need a new one anyway. Oh, I know, you're gonna...